causes us to triumph. He is not caught off guard by any of our life situations. Everything, the hardship, the trial, the storm, it's not happening to us. It's happening for us. For we know that all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. So don't give up. We don't have to worry. Our God is intentional. Let's go.
Hello, and welcome to this time of worship together. We're so glad you've chosen to worship with us today. My name is Emily Wilton, and I serve as the Breakthrough Coordinator for the United Methodists of Greater New Jersey. Today's worship service is themed around seeing the mountains in our lives as opportunities instead of obstacles. Now please join me in the call to worship. Elizabeth believed in God, and God made her mother of the baptizer. For nothing is impossible with God. Mary believed in God, and God made her mother of Jesus the Savior. For nothing is impossible with God. We believe that with God's help, we can move mountains. For nothing is impossible with God. God, nothing is impossible with you. You called Elizabeth and blessed her with a miracle. You moved her mountain and gave us the baptizer. You called Mary to be the mother of our Savior. You moved her heart to believe the impossible. Move us today to seek your will and desires. Give us thirst to seek you every day in prayer. Make us go deeper in your word, your love, and your mercy. And always remind us that nothing is impossible with you. Amen. This past week, United Methodists of Greater New Jersey supported 28 Hope Centers with food, meals, and beginning to reopen childcare programs. During the pandemic, the mission has not stopped, and that's because of you. Each week, a portion of your offering goes to support mission in the Greater New Jersey area and around the world. On behalf of people who were fed this week, thank you. God has provided us with all that we have. It is our honor to give back to God. Let us give with the joy and faith of Mary and Elizabeth. If your church already has online giving or other means for receiving the offering set up, please feel free to do so. Otherwise, you can give to your church through the GNJ website at gnjumc.org. And then click Give to Your Local Church at the top of the homepage. also consider giving to the Miracles Everywhere COVID-19 Fund, which is helping to feed people who are out of work. You can do this on the same webpage. Please join me in prayer. Awesome God, Mary and Elizabeth's unwavering faith introduced the world to Jesus. You call us to have the same faith and to believe that nothing is impossible with you, to believe that mountains can be moved and people can be saved. Bless these gifts so that we can continue building your kingdom until you come again in victory. Amen. Our scripture reading today is Luke chapter 1, verses 39 to 45. Listen now for a word from the Lord. A few days later, Mary hurried to the hill country of Judea, to the town where Zechariah lived. She entered the house and greeted Elizabeth. At the sound of Mary's greeting, Elizabeth's child leaped within her, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Elizabeth gave a glad cry and exclaimed to Mary, "God has blessed you above all women, and your child is blessed. Why am I so honored that the mother of my Lord should visit me? When I heard your greeting, the baby in my womb jumped for joy. You are blessed because you believed that the Lord would do what he said." This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Good morning. My name is Gina Yeske. I'm the director of small groups of Greater New Jersey, and I'm glad that we have this time together this morning to talk a little bit about faith that moves mountains. I don't know about you, but I've often wondered, why do we delegate some of the most powerful stories of the Bible to just certain seasons? So why don't we preach the resurrection of Jesus in the fall, or the coming of the Holy Spirit in January? Why do we take the stories that lead up to Jesus' birth and cram them into just a few weeks right before Christmas. Well, today we're going to depart from that practice and consider God's miraculous work in the lives of Mary and Elizabeth. Elizabeth and Mary are two ordinary women who take on what they know is impossible, but do so by leaning in on their faith. Today, I'm hoping that we can be encouraged and inspired by their willingness to allow God to work in the midst of their impossible situations. Will you pray with me, please? Amazing God, I ask that you use my words to inspire your people to see that you are at work in their lives, especially those places where they're facing troubles and trials of all kinds. Amen. I can look back at my life, and there are plenty of times when I've said to myself, I can't do that, I shouldn't do that, I would never imagine even doing that. And too often, that is just the case. I have defeated myself before I even gave it a try, or a chance, or a second thought. When faced with seemingly impossible challenges, I let my fear overcome my faith. How about you? Have you found yourself in situations where you just could not imagine how you're going to manage? Even today, you might be facing impossible challenges. Maybe they're financial worries, or relational issues, or health concerns. I know over the past few months of this pandemic, it has created all kinds of new trials for many of us. And likely, as we look at the days ahead, we are questioning, how are we going to make it through? I believe we can learn something valuable with the lessons of faith and trust from the lives of Mary and Elizabeth when it comes to finding God in the midst of impossible situations. When we strip away all the lure and the promise of Advent and Christmas, and we focus on the life circumstances of these ordinary women, we discover a message of power and liberation that God is offering to all who has faced impossible situations. Mary and Elizabeth, two women who are often overlooked by a society, are the center of these stories. These two women, whose pregnancy would bring about the salvation of all the world, are at this moment considered inconsequential by the world itself, yet favored in the eyes of God. These two women, who were not allowed to serve in the temple and were only allowed to worship from a distance, are filled with the Holy Spirit. These two women, who would have been forbidden to speak in public, now have been given a prophetic word to share with all the world for all time to come. These two women, who were forgotten and shunned by their family and friends, their community and society, God uses their faithfulness to forever change the world. Of course, we see all these things through the rearview mirror of their story. But let's be clear. While both Mary and Elizabeth took their circumstances as a blessing, that did not mean that they were easy. Mary faces real danger. She could be stoned if her virginity came into question. And Elizabeth, well, Elizabeth has troubles of her own. For years, she had been scorned because of her inability to give her husband an heir. And now her husband has been struck mute due to his unbelief that his wife would bear him a child. Mary and Elizabeth's faith didn't make the challenges disappear, but in faith, God gave them the strength to persevere and face them head on. When I think about this story, I imagine Mary having just begun to grasp the seriousness of her yes to God and all that that would entail. And she needed a safe space to consider her new circumstances. While Elizabeth is her cousin and hopefully her advocate for her choice, Mary must have wondered as she traveled over the hills, how would her news be met? But the moment Elizabeth greets her, it overturns the social norms of condemning Mary and instead names her pregnancy as a miraculous gift from God, just as Elizabeth sees her own pregnancy as a miracle. Now, this is not your kind of baby sprinkle moment. Instead, this message proclaims what kind of God we believe in, one who brings hope and salvation to ordinary people who are suffering. The belief of a God who brings about impossible is a great comfort to those who are in need and in trouble. The promise that God does not forget the least, the last, and the lost. Mary's words are not merely a personal affirmation of faith. Instead, they inspire all of those who are suffering, all of those who are oppressed, all of those who are in need of the God of impossibilities to enter their situation. Mary models for us an open and receptive spirit that God will use to bring about impossible. In a sermon written shortly before he was executed by the Nazis, Dietrich Bonhoeffer stated, "This is not the gentle, tender, dreamy Mary whom we often see in paintings. This song is none of the sweet, nostalgic, or even playful tones of some of our Christmas carols. It instead is hard, strong, relentless about the power of God and the powerlessness of humankind. In all of my long years of being in the church, of knowing the Christmas story backwards and forwards, I never thought of this story in this way. This encounter of Mary and Elizabeth has illustrated God's liberating power for those who are oppressed, and God's intentional reorienting of unjust systems. It names that God will topple the proud and uplift the humble. Mary's words proclaim that God sees the plight of those who are suffering and will reverse their circumstances. Today, our world is in need of knowing that our God cares about all that is happening, including our political and economic and social realities. God cares about the plight of the poor and the hungry and the oppressed. God is there for those who are facing impossible situations. Mary and Elizabeth allow their faith to guide their responses to the troubles that they face. Their unwavering faith introduced the world to Jesus. We are called to be people of the same faith. So I wonder, how are you opening up yourself to be used and to be a voice of hope and freedom to those who are suffering? I wonder, in your personal life, is there someone who is facing impossible situations that need you to be their Elizabeth? Someone who is willing to look beyond the judgment of society and see how God is working? Can we be God's presence for one another? And finally, Mary and Elizabeth's stories are not just about what is happening to them in this place or time, but instead it is how God wove their lives, their experiences, and their witness into the history of God's redemptive work. Today, God is inviting you, you and your congregation, to be included in this story of redemption. How will you use your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness so that no one will suffer alone? No one will be overlooked because you have faithfully come alongside them to face an impossible mountain. I hope that this message has encouraged and inspired you to go forward and know that the power of the Holy Spirit, the companionship of Jesus Christ, and the might of our God go with you to face and move mountains. Have a blessed day.
Please join me in praying for our world. God of Mary and Elizabeth, God of the hopeless, the downtrodden, and the oppressed, we ask you to hear our prayers, the prayers of ordinary people, as we face seemingly impossible circumstances. We pray for those who have been affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, for those who are sick and suffering, those who have died and their loved ones, and for those who have suffered economically, mentally, and spiritually. We pray for the healing of minds, bodies, and spirits. We lament the death of George Floyd and countless others who have suffered violence for the color of their skin. We praise you as the God of power and liberation for all who are oppressed. My white siblings and I confess our sin of complicity in systems that perpetuate racial oppression instead of participating in your liberating work. We repent and we commit ourselves to the faithful work of racial justice. God, through Mary and Elizabeth, two women overlooked by society, you brought forth the salvation of the world. May we, the church, the body of Christ, follow their example of deep faith in the face of impossible circumstances. May we not seek the easy way, but the faithful way. May we not seek to make ourselves powerful, but to transform the world through the power of your love. We pray for the leaders of our state, nation, and world. Be with them as they shape policies and practices. Let them not only hear the cries for justice, but heed them. Lord, we pray also for the leadership of our church and the Church Universal, for our bishop and district superintendents, and for all those clergy in our conference and around the world who are getting ready to leave churches and begin to serve new ones. May your Holy Spirit be with them in this time of transition. God, be with all clergy as they continue to lead your people through a pandemic and to be people of faith in a world where it sometimes feels impossible. Give us your guidance and wisdom, your rest and your strength. And finally, Lord, empower us all to be like Elizabeth for one another, to renounce judgment, to offer a space of gentleness to each other, and to celebrate the work that you, God, are doing in each and every one of us. We pray this in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Liberator. Amen.
Wonderful grace of Jesus, greater than all my sin. How shall my tongue describe it? Where shall its praise begin? Taking away my burden, setting my spirit free. For the wonderful grace of Jesus reaches me. Wonderful the matchless grace of Jesus. Rolling sea, higher than the mountains, sparkling like like a fountain, all sufficient grace from even me. Broader than the scope of my transgressions, greater far than all my sin and shame. Oh, magnify the precious name of Jesus, praise his name. Wonderful grace of Jesus, reaching to all.
Friends, thank you so much for worshiping with us today. As our time together ends and we move into the week, may every mountain you face become an opportunity for God to work in you and through you. May you have the courage to speak to those mountains and every obstacle in your life. Go in faith to love God, serve one another, and by God's grace, may you move mountains. Amen.